Hello there, everybody! DModGmod here, and welcome back to another chapter of Fire Emblem! In the last chapter, we met one of the four Fangs, Lloyd. And despite him being so infamous as a Black Fang member, he was actually really nice and respectable. He had great honor and great dignity. Unfortunately, though, he died. Not at our hands, but at someone else's. And yeah, that's not good. However, besides that, we've also been sent on a quest because we really need the aid of the royal family there that we are in. Well, the area we're in, we really need the help of the royal family there. Unfortunately, though, they're not really willing to help us due to circumstances, since it seems the Fire Emblem, a sacred treasure, has been taken from where it's properly meant to be. And in return for finding said item, they said they're going to help us find the secret shrine that we've been talking about recently. And that being said, I think that sums it all up. Let's get into it. Chapter 24, Unfulfilled... Excuse me. Unfulfilled Burp, yes. Anyways though, for real though. Chapter 24, Unfulfilled Heart. Let's do it. The Born Royal Family is a pageant of power, love, and hate. Edward finds himself embroiled in their troubles. He has been sent to recover the Burn Family treasure, the Fire Emblem. It has been stolen from the palace vault. Edward enters the royal palace seeking clues. Alright. Let's do it. Chapter 24, Unfulfilled Heart. And yes, for those who are curious, yes, the Fire Emblem is actually an item in the series. It's not just the name of the game. We finally arrived. I can't believe they built the palace in these mountains. Burn is the only country on the continent where wyverns still fly. If it's wyvern riders, I imagine this castle is best defended anywhere. I agree. Look at the path leading up to the mountain's face. It'd be impossible to scale that in a direct assault. Defenders positioned higher up would have a clear advantage. Even the best soldiers would be taken out with ease. Huh. Look at that. They don't have any sentries posted. They must have a lot of faith in their defenses. Look at these surroundings. They'd probably make do simply with patrols within the castle. The mighty Burn. It's not like it as an enemy. And yet, from this impenetrable fortress, a treasure was stolen. Perhaps the king really is responsible for all this. It's hard to imagine any thief cracking Burn's defenses. You're right. But I can't imagine why the king would do this. To find the Fire Emblem, we're going to need clues. Listen, why don't we try sneaking into the castle? That's what I was waiting for. I like the way you think. Whatever happens, we must not be caught. If it looks impossible, turn around and come back here. Got it. Of course. Here we go. This is an inner garden? Shh, someone's coming this way. Here, into this thicket. Hello, Zephiel. Ah, Gunniver? I think it's Gunniver. I could be wrong on that. Ah, Gunniver, where have you been? Wait, oh, how have you been? I've been fine. If you would come and see me every day, I'd be even better, much, much better. Every day? Well, that's an awful lot, but I'll come by as often as possible. Offer your dish, sister. Yippee! Aww! Gunniver! Where are you, lass? Here I am, father. Welcome home. Ah, there you are. Were you a good girl while I was gone? Come, give your father a kiss. You're as adorable as ever. Well met, father. Zephiel. Ah, you take the same unpleasant tone as your mother. What? Silence. What brings you to my castle? Murdoch. Yes, my lord? We were hunting in the forest earlier. We found this and thought Gunniver might like it. A baby fox? How cute! It's so very cute! Is it for me? Really? Do you like it? Yes, I do! Thank you! I do love it, brother. Gunniver, go play for a while. Okay. Come on, let's go! Lovely little fox. Aw, it's just so cute, man! I told you to stay away from the castle. Yes, I know. I beg your pardon. I've heard that Gunniver was ill and I was worried. Ha. You mean the king to see if she would die, don't you? Huh? Wow, this guy's got a hatred towards him. I beg your pardon, Majesty. That. Hold your tongue, Murdoch. Do not forget whom you serve. The king of... Okay, this guy's a douche. He definitely took the Fire Emblem. I'm fully believing that. It's alright, Murdoch. Brother, I would never want to see Gunniver harmed in... You and your mother think of nothing more than stealing my throne. You plague me. Return to the maids. As you wish. I beg your leave, father. Oh. It's official. This guy's a problem. No matter how I warn him, he comes. Why is it that the very sight of him tries my faith and so? I surely have my own flesh and blood, yet. Hehehe. It is jealousy, my king. Huh? Who's there? It's I, Sonya. You. Well, is the emblem safe? Yes, I have it in my possession. It is all as we planned. It is unlikely, but the queen might attempt to win the emblem back. Are you prepared? I will not fail. It is secreted away within the Black Fang's fortress. Keep it concealed until dusk of the 10th day, then return it to me. As you will, your grace. But what are my other requests? One of the four Fangs will tend to it. There will be no mistakes. However, General Murdoch, the man protecting the prince. He is young, yet well respected. Shall we finish him too? Murdoch, his birth is low. Yet his combat skills have worn him the title of a Wyvern General. It'd be a great blow if Vern were to lose him. I'll think of something to remove him from Zephyr's side. Will that do? Yes, it would be a great help. Wait. What? What is it? I sent someone. Where? Father? Brother? Where are you? Do not worry, it's my daughter. Of course. Do not forget the Black Fang's role once we are successful. Of course. Now be gone, quickly. Farewell. Zephyl, this kid, it... Huh? Where's my brother? He had an errand to perform and left. Oh no, 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 I wanted to play! Come, Guinevere. I'll play with you. No, I want to play with him, not you. I'll go and call him back. Here, hold my fox. Attend me? Yes, my lord? Take this beast and... Oh. What a douche, okay. Zephyl, you knave. Trying to steal my Gunnover's love. You will learn your play. Oh. That was close, I was afraid to catch us. This is worse than I'd imagined. The Black Fang have already reached in the king. The plans for Lycia have failed, and now they're targeting Burn. A country as powerful as Burn moves, peace knows no hope. When order desires its powerful princes, calling dragons back. Does he wish to embroil the world in chaos? Whatever his plans, he must be stopped at any cost. Right, find the file and return to the queen. If we do that, we can point us toward the Shrine of Seals. We go to the Black Fang Fortress. That's our goal. I must meet with everyone and seek out their fortress. I wonder if Elibor and the others are well. Please, Ninian. That's all you've spoken of since they left. I understand your concern for Lord Elibor, but... Mills, you don't have to hide anything from me. But you must not fall in love with him, you know? We are different from them. I know, but I cannot... Ninian, where are you going? I need time to think. May I be alone, please? That must suck, man. And oh, crap! You better hurry and rejoin the others. Ah, crap, look, it's a Wyvern Rider. She's coming closer. Has she seen us? No, it's not us she's seen, it's Nils! Let's go, Hector! Okay! But, who are you? Light green hair, crimson eyes, no mistake. You're one of Lord Nurgle's lost toys. Yes, found you at last. What are you... Why can't I sense you? What happened to your bodyguards? I heard they were tough. I wanted to see for myself. Well, you're here, so they can't be too far away, can they? Come on, boys. Scream. Call your friends to you. I'm too weary of waiting. I am not known for my patience. I'm the one you're looking for. I'm Handle Boy. You've come. I've been looking forward to this. Looking forward. What do you mean? The chance to crush you, and hand the children over to Lord Nurgle. Nurgle, so you're on one of his dogs, are you? I'll not be called a dog by you, Blackheart. Sure, we have a contract with the Black Fang, but I am loyal to one master only. He who sits on the throne of Burn. Then why are you in the employ of the Black... It's been far too much talking. Let's get started, shall we? I've long hunted for someone to test my strength against. Make this last a while, will you? I want to enjoy this. Listen up, everyone, it's playtime! Come on out! The palace has promised to stay out of this. Be as wild as you will.
Zachary, our allies are hidden here and there to avoid being spotted. This is not to our advantage. We must scan everyone quickly. Alright, let's see here. Oh. Well, where... Oh, they're all over here. Okay, I get it. So we have our lords over here, and then everybody else is down there. I got how this chapter works, but the question is, where's the boss? The boss is... There she is. A whopping 60 HP. Ooh. That's some pretty powerful character. That's a pretty powerful character. Now, besides the point, I'm not really concerned about that, because... let's see here. Let me think here. Who do I want to bring? Let me check out the enemy's units. Because I got a plan going into this, because... If we're being honest here, there may be some pretty powerful guys out there, but we've already seen that numbers can definitely override them. And, ooh, who are you? Oh, you're a sage of elf. Ah, okay, we need to kill you as soon as possible, then. You're gonna be a problem. Okay, we got armories, we got vendors, and then we got a bunch of fortresses by the castle. Interesting. Okay, we got some knights. We got lots of magic units, I'm seeing. We got tons of magic units and lots of mobile units, including wyvern riders. So that's never fun dealing with. Just saying, just being honest. So what I'm thinking is for our units, I'm not gonna bring Rebecca. I'm gonna bring Raph instead. Actually, then again, maybe we should bring Wallace. He's pretty bulky. You know what? I'll forget Fior for this chapter and we'll bring Wallace instead. I think that's a good idea. Now then, let's check out everyone's gear to make sure no one's short-ended. Elliewood, you could use transfer, take, you could use a vulnerary. So we'll give you one of those. Hector, we're going to give you the torch. You don't need that anymore. Lynn, you're fine. Will's fine. You're fine. I'll take the torch away from him. There we go. Marcus, you get... I'll give you an armor slayer, and I'll give you a javelin. I think that's definitely equipping him with enough, so that'll do it for you. And I will give you a vulnerary, because honestly, we have so many vulnerabilities, I really don't care. Ninian, you're fine, as always. You're fine. You're fine. I'm not gonna bother taking anything off you guys. You're fine. You're good, and you're fine too. Okay, but now, the thing I was talking about earlier, I'm pretty sure you guys remember this, but you guys remember that special item we got last time from the old man, the Earth Seal. I've been debating on how to use this thing up for a while now, and here's basically my arguments for each character quickly. Hector. I don't think I'm going to be using on Hector simply because he's already strong enough. With a level cap of 20, and he's got some pretty powerful stats to back him up, as you're going to see here. With a capped out defense and some pretty awesome stats everywhere else, I don't really see any use of leveling up Hector any further. So we're not going to use on a Hector. And then when it comes to Lynn, it's really just between Lynn and Elliewood, because if you look at their stats here, Elliewood has... Let me see here. I want to make sure I'm getting this right. More strength than Lynn. Lynn has more skill and speed. I think Elliewood has more luck. Yeah, Elliewood has more luck. Elliewood's a bit more bulky on each side. So I think I'm going to use it on Elliewood. I might regret this, but I'm thinking I'm going to use it on Elliewood. So let's go down here. Take the Earth Seal. And oh, crud. Wait a minute. Am I thinking the wrong item? If I was thinking the wrong item this entire time, I'm gonna feel like an idiot. Cause I totally could be, I totally could. Let me see here, wait a minute. Did I get the... Oh, some units, not all you. Oopsies. Well, I'm an idiot. Whatever then, looks like we're not gonna upgrade anything. Let's just quickly save our game. And you know what, we haven't got a fortune in a little bit, how about we go check it out? Give me a reading. Oh, this is the affinity chart thing, so you can actually see which units are compatible with one another. So as you can see here, it's going to show you all the characters that a unit's compatible with, which can be very helpful, especially if you want to build relationships. As you can see, Eliwood can become friends with a lot of characters. So yeah, that's basically how that works. Now that being said, I'd like to check out the fortune teller. Who's this? Okay, she's out, and... Oh! Hey, Nils, I guess you can be my new fortune teller. Alright, a moment, please. The enemy seeks to scatter and destroy. You must come together. I see wyvern riders. They cloud the sky. You should take archers, as many as possible. The leader of the enemy forces. I sense something. There is an energy. If you're able to avoid the leader, you should do so. Don't move about too much. Staying in one place will make the battle easier. That's it. Okay, so apparently camping is the good idea for the strategy. With that being said, let's go save our game one more time. Let's get this fight started. Iron Lance level 14! Hooray! And oh, hey there, Pent! We'll help too. Tell us what to do. You as well, Lady Louise? Of course. No need for concern. She is quite skilled with a bow. Those burned wyvern riders will be sorry to meet her. Despite what you may think, I shoot much better than our dancer sing. I believe I can be of some small assistance. I understand. Thank you for your help. I know. What now? Let me give you this. It's from Lord Ephos. What is it? A heaven seal. It reveals hidden strengths. It only works for a select few, but... there's an air of mystery to it. You think you can use it? No, it won't work for me. Wait for the proper time and have the other two try it. It might not work now, but I'm sure that you will all be able to use it at some point. Just keep trying. I understand. Thank you very much. And we got a heaven seal! Is this the item I was thinking of? Oh, Morphin Pet? Miss Zachary, is that right? Please, forget about my title and standing in the country. You are a tactician, and I'll do as you command. Well then, I hope we'll work well together. Oh, we will, Pent. Oh, we will. Okay, let's get this started. Heaven seal, let me make sure. Is this the item I was thinking of? Right, this is the one that I was thinking of. The heaven seal. Now, it only has one use, as you can see it here, and I don't know when I want to use this. But I can't use it now, as you can see. So, for now, we're not going to be able to use it. Now, that being said, let's get into the chapter itself. So, I'm going to worry more about down here, first of all. And that's not going to work. How do you do, Kness? Okay, that's good. Let me just see who can attack you. You can't, and you can't, and you can? No, okay. So no matter what, Kness is fine if I move him like this. Okay, so we'll have Kness attack this guy, and hopefully get both hits connect. It's 67, so I expect it to miss somewhat, but hopefully they both connect. Come on, Kness. Come on. There you go. Nice job, Kness. And level up. Level 6. Hey, I called it. Woo! I'm a fortune teller. I'm Nils. I'm Hannah, I think her name was. Yeah. Okay, now moving up, we're going to take our more bulky units, and we're going to put them at the front. So I'm going to have Wilson in the back, and we're basically what I'm going to be doing calling the screw what flying units strategy. Now over here, now we got some houses to visit, how about we check them out quickly? I've heard some stories about the Black Fang. I heard there's a sword fighter who wields the fearsome Lightbrand. No, he's not here now, but you might run into him somewhere. You should be careful. The Lightbrand is a magic sword. It'll cut you if you're close and hurl magic at you from afar. Step lightly if you know he's on the battlefield. So apparently this guy has some pretty amazing weapon. We'll have to keep our eye out for that. Now, Guy, I'm gonna have you go visit this place. Do you know anyone named Zachary? You see, I once helped out a weird traveler. I wonder what would become of that poor wanderer. I guess I know you? Apparently I know her. That's kind of neat, actually. And Wallace, go to town! I forgot how amazing Wallace is. Blow him away! Generals are so awesome, man. They're so cool. I love generals. They're so nice. Okay. Now you're taken care of. What's the Rival Rider's range? Pretty big, actually. So what I'm thinking is... I'll have Sane move over here, so we have the bushes to help recover. And you are a sword wielder, so we'll equip our lance. I'll have you wait here. And I guess Hawkeye can start moving forward, but I don't want to go too far forward, so there we go. Now over here, how can you move? You can attack Ninian. You can't really do anything, and then you guys are still have to come all the way around the mountain, so I don't have to worry about that. Okay, with that being said then, is there any archers nearby? I don't see any archers around the map, actually. Yeah, I don't see, like, any... Is there a single archer? There isn't! Heath can do whatever he wants this chapter. Finally, a chance to show off what Heath's good for, man. And, of course, as soon as I say that, he has an enemy that he can basically... He's never going to hit in for the life of him. Perfect. Okay, then. I think, Ninian, I'll just have her go up here. And for now, I'll have you go over here, and then we'll have you go here. So up here are our little lord characters. Should I? I know Peck could definitely take on all these fools, so I think I'll have Pent go over here, accompanied by Elliewood. Then again, this guy could probably attack Elliewood for that, right? No, he can't. Okay. And I think I'll have... Actually, what? No, Louise, go with your husband. Go over there. Well, you guys take care of that. I'll have Hector go over here. I think I'll have Elliewood go in here, and then I'll have Lin go in this one. Okay, let's see what happens. Not a whole lot. Okay, there we go. So, oh crap, I left Raph right open. What am I doing? And you're gonna go for Sane, and even if you do hit, it won't be that bad, because Sane has a crap ton of HP. Now I wish I made Sane a paladin, you know? But then again, I couldn't tell the future, unfortunately. And oh crap! Okay, Will can take it even if it's a double attack. But I'm learning I need to be a bit more careful. And yeah, don't challenge Pent. You're just gonna get yourself literally burnt alive. Gone. And oh crap, I just realized I completely forgot about Pent and Luis's bios. Okay, when the enemy turns N, I'll activate the bios. Can we get a dodge? We can't. Dang it. Okay, now their turn's over. And oh, it's a survive battle. I didn't realize that. We just have to survive to the end. So we can literally just kind of camp. So if I can get everybody in this circle over here, we'll have a force so strong that they really can't touch me. So I think that's what we're going to try and do, honestly. But yeah, with that being said, Pent and Luis's bios. Go.
You've already seen Pent in action for two whole chapters at this point. And frankly, being honest, I think it's safe to say Pent is no one to screw around with in the slightest. He is a sage class, and a sage class uses magic and stabs, which basically means he's got great offensive abilities with magic, almost one-shotting like everything he comes across at this point of the game, and he also has stabs, which means he can work as a healer when he's not attacking, which means he fills multiple roles and he's very, very useful on the team. It is worth noting, though, that while his stats right now are phenomenal, his level growths up are kind of shabby to balance it out, so just keep that in mind. But yeah, Pent's pretty freaking
awesome.
Well,
I really do like Will, and Rebecca's pretty cool too. I won't lie, Louise is something that's extremely hard to outshine as an archer. She is pretty dang awesome, having a very powerful silver bow when she comes with you, and because of her stats called Constitution, which we're not going to really get into the depth of it, but because of it, just know that she will not get weighted down by her weapon choice for the most part, meaning that her silver bow will often attack twice with incredible power. And all around, she's got some pretty awesome stats, and she can definitely hold her own. She's very, very dependable, and when she says she's might be a small assistance, she's lying, because she's great at like everything an archer's supposed to do. And honestly, she's probably the best archer in the game.
Oh my god! That's a lot of money! Wow, okay. Anyways though, hope you enjoyed the bios, let's get back into combat. Just realized how much freaking money she had on her, wow. Let me see here, how do we do against this guy with the rapier? Relatively well, but not enough for me to be confident about that, so how about we just do this instead? There's the times four I was talking about. Hector is going to destroy him, but let's use up the hammer instead just to keep it nice and simple. Save the Brave Axe uses because the Brave Axe is going to be very, very helpful. And I love how the lance goes right through Hector and nothing happens. It just goes right through him and nothing changes. I love that. It's so funny looking. Now, before I move there, can you attack me? You can't, and then you are not gonna probably move from that spot knowing bosses for some reason. And then, you will take four, let's see. 12 times 2, 12 times 2s, but you could get a critical hit and end them off early. And with so many uses, let's just go for the manicotti. Go, Lin! There's that crit I was talking about. Good job, Lin. Sweet. And I think that's a level 12, Lord? No, 13. Dang it. I got lucky once with the guessing. Oh, well. Okay, now let me think here. You're there. I could longbow you, but that's not really worth it. So how about instead what I do is I have Canast attacks with Flux Magic, which is going to absolutely destroy this man, because Wyvern Rider's resistances are pretty bad. Unlike their counterpart, the Pegasus Rider's, which is actually pretty good. There we go. But yeah, Wyvern Riders are kind of the opposite of Pegasus Riders. They're both pretty fast and offensive, but when it comes to defensives, they're the opposite. Where Wyvern Riders are better defensively, and Pegasus Riders are better at resistance. Now that being said, I don't have any sword. I just realized I don't have like any sword characters down here except for Guy. That's not good. Okay, let's see here. There's like no way for me to take cover before attacking him. I want to save the killing edge, so I'm thinking we'll just go for the steel sword. There's one. Can we get a dodge? Dang it. And there we go. Okay, not bad. And we got a level up. What level are you now, Guy? 9. Maybe I should be using him a bit more. Just saying. Okay, next up. This guy. You're a lance user. Hawkeye's an axe user. We see where this is going. I could take no actually, just use the hand axe. Let's not use up the killer axe if you don't have to. And oh! Dang, Hawkeye. Nice and powerful. And you still can't move anywhere, so I'm not really worried. That being said, I'm gonna move Saint over here. I'll keep the sword for now. I'll have you move forward like so, and then Raph. You don't have any way to heal, do you? You don't. Okay. Well, you do have the way to hit this guy. It's only 8. That's not very accurate. Okay, then. Never mind. Where can you guys move to? Whoa, wait. This guy. Right, he has a bow, so he's going to be able to attack us. Okay. I'll move Raph here, then. Okay, now that being said, we can get back to the fight over here. We'll go over this way, and then I can either do that, or... Ooh, we're not having the best results with Will over here. Can this guy attack him? He can't, okay. And you can't either. So really, wait, is there anyone else over here? No, there's no one else to attack Will, so this is fine if I do this. Okay, good. Iron Bow will do a lot of damage in there. 24 to be exact. That's right, people, I can count. I took math class, I sucked at it, but I did. Go. Now, this guy down here, I think I equipped Marcus with a sword, if I'm right. Yes, I did. And even though it's not a proper sword for fighting these type of guys, it's still a sword, so it's still gonna be really good here. Nice dodge. I have only 7 chances to hit. Ooh. Yeah, that guy wasn't hitting us, to say it simply. Okay, now that being said, Heath, I'm gonna have you take on this Wyvern Rider with your own weapon. 79. Okay, so it really doesn't matter. Let's just go for the Steel Lance then. Come on, baby! There you go. And with a level up, I guess that really is how you train your dragon. Okay, I'm sorry! I've been resisting that one for a bit, and... terrible level up. I deserve it for that bad pun. Okay, yeah, Will's the one that actually wanted to be healed for now, so let's go heal up Will. There we go. You'll be very helpful to chat with all the flying units. Yeah, and then Oswin, I'm gonna have you move forward. Or should I have you move backward, actually, to help with the other guys? I think I'll do that, actually. And then you, my friend, I'm going to... I think I'll dance for Heath to get him moving again, like so. There we go, and then I'll have Heath go up here. Because I'm debating right now. Do I want to bring all my units down here into this little area over here? Or do I want to bring them up over this way? Because it looks like there's going to be a lot less units coming from over here if I do up here and over there. Then again, I could try and get everyone into the castle area over here. With all the fortresses, it'll be really easy to win with all that extra stuff. I don't know. Then again, if I go down here... You know what? Yeah, I'll bring everyone else down here. That's what I'll do. So I'm going to have Elliewood start to get moving this way. And it's a good thing I gave you a vulnerary, because it looks like you're going to be using it a bit here. There we go. Now let's take out these two while I'm at it. Yeah, Louise, you just obliterate this man, so let's just go for it. And oh, I love the pink! I love the pink on that bow. That looks so awesome. I mean, I like the blue too that Will has, but like the pink, I don't know, it stands out so much more. I like it a lot. Yes, I'm a guy who likes pink. Get over it. Okay, I'm joking. Don't worry about it. I guess, Kent, you can go fight this guy. And I'm sorry, but watching Shine compared to Elfire is like watching a match compared to the sun, if I'm being honest here. There we go. Okay, then we got this guy, which he can't move because he's in the mountains. He can't traverse the mountains, but he can't really do anything, so I'm not worried. Now then, this guy, how are we going to attack? He's not even a concern yet, so let's not even bother fighting him. Let's just go over here and enemy phase. Basically nothing happened, hooray, except Sane getting attacked by a bow, which he should dodge. Thank you, Sane. Another one. Nice job, Sane, there we go. Okay. Here we go. Let's get out, keep going down here. I do think that going down here and having everybody kind of hang out down here would be the best strategy, because the boss, if we don't have to kill her, let's not even try. Because she's a little powerful, if you couldn't tell. Now, you guys can go over this way. Now, Guy, I want you to be over here, not to visit him. Wait, what's your HP looking like, Guy? Halfway, okay, so we'll have you do this. I'll give you a vulnerary, and then you can fight on this axe fighter who should just get demolished by you. Now, Hawkeye, you're up. That's definitely worth the trade-off because he can't even hurt me, and oh my god, Hawkeye! You're not even using the killer axe and you're critting all the dang time. I love it, but dang. Okay, now you're next, and 6 times 2, is anyone else 2 gonna hit me? No, so I guess it wouldn't be worth it in the long run. Okay, wrong character. Then again, maybe I should attack this guy. Can he hit me if I do that? Yes, he can. Okay, so then maybe not. Yeah, you know what? We'll just have Rap attack this guy. Go for the short bow. Let's go for it. Crit. Nice. And still doesn't get the KO, but hey, he did a lot of damage. I'll take it. Whatever. There you go. Now I'm going to have Sane. Then again, actually, I kind of want Sane to go over here. Yeah, I'll do that, and then I'll have Wallace take on this guy. Yeah, definitely the Silver Lance. I don't even know why I'm bothered looking at the axe. Oh no, he has an Armor Slayer. Too bad he's never gonna get to use it. And we got another level 2 general. Yay, I called it again. Alright. Now, over here. Let's see here. Will, you can almost knock out this guy. What's your attack range? You would be able to get him. That's kind of crappy. Kness, can you knock him out? You most certainly can if you get both hits. Come on, Kness. You got this. Can we get another one? Oh, that's a crit. Okay, yep, he's gone. Nice. Okay, let's see here. Guy will take care of him, no problem. This guy can't do anything this turn. These guys can come, but Wallace is going to absolutely destroy them, so I'm not worried about them. Yeah, this is looking pretty good. I can use this on Elliewood, though, to get some free experience with Ninian. There we go. And for now, yeah, we'll just kind of have our units just kind of chill out here, I guess you could say. Heath, I'll have you go over there. Marcus, you don't really have a reason to move anywhere. Yeah, I guess with that being said, we can just kind of leave our units here. Because, like I said, all we're going to do now is just get our units into the center, and then I think I'll fast forward the rest of the chapter, because the looks of it, nothing else is really going to be happening. And miss. Good job. This should be a double attack. Just no. Okay, I guess the steel sword really does lower guy's speed quite a bit. And yeah, no reinforcements either. This won't be hard at all then. Okay, even less of a chance to hit with the iron sword. Okay, we're definitely doing this then. There's one. Good luck hitting that, and goodbye. Alright, this is going pretty sweet. And, ooh, weapon level. Nice. Okay, now that being said, I should probably attack this guy. Yeah, get the chip damage in there. There we go. Good job, Raph. Now, Hawkeye, I'll have you go finish this guy off. You know what? I'll use the hand axe, but knowing Hawkeye, he's gonna get a crit anyways. Oh, Jesus, Hawkeye! It's 3 times in a row, man! Guardian of the Desert? No kidding. Jeez, Hawkeye. Okay, I'll move Wallace here to cover anyone who tries to go through this way, because they're just gonna get met with Wallace and die instantly, really. Then I think... I don't really know if I should... I have anything else to do, so I think I'll just have you do there. You do there. Great, great English, Zachary. Wind wait there, and yeah, the champion's basically said and done. I want Nini to get some support points, I guess you could call them, so I'm gonna have him go over there. And then you guys can just kind of go over this way. Okay. And then, yeah, that's really about it. Unless something changes, then we're already done. I kid you not. Okay, I guess I'll have Guy start moving forward then. I'll have Hawkeye go up this way. Raph can go up here too. And I'm gonna keep Wallace here. And yeah, I guess we'll just end the turn again. No, that's it! That's actually it. We can just end the turn again. Oh, there we go. There's the repurpose we're looking for. Okay, with that being said, let's get everyone back here so we can get ready to take them all on all together. I'm gonna let them come to us. I'm not gonna bother going to them. Okay. With that being said, Guy, keep moving forward. I'll have you go into the fortress section for better cover. End the turn there, and we'll keep going forward. Okay, here come the flying angels of death or something. And oh! Okay, there's a lot of them coming now, actually. Alright then. Yeah, okay, they're gonna be reaching us next turn then. New plan! We are going to run away like sissies! Yay! Strategy! But actually, no, we're just gonna move as far back as possible before confronting them, because that way we can sell out a little bit more time. So we'll just do this. So yeah, just gonna move everyone back, because if we can stall even a little bit more time, the more the better, honestly. And Heath, I don't have to worry about you, you can just go way out there. So can Marcus. It's more of these guys I want out of there as soon as possible, so I'll have you get going. I should've used Dance, but oh well, I'm an idiot. I'll have you get going. Let's see, can you guys attack our little lovey-dovey couple over there? Nope, okay. I don't have to retreat like this, but I'm just trying to stall a turn, so when they actually do arrive here, we can just slaughter them all, and that'll be the end of it. And that will do it. Okay, let's go forward. I mean, there's a lot of flyers coming in. Like, there's 8 right there. And that looks like it's all that's gonna be. So let's see, how far can you hit? Okay, we can still make this work, so we can do that. I'll have Lin go over this way. Belly will go over here. And oh shoot. Okay, Elliwood's getting attacked unless I can save him, but Elliwood should be fine for a turn. Okay, so I will be taking 2 attacks total. Unless I put a bodyguard here. Put a bodyguard there. You can't attack Lin, right? No, you can't, and you can't either. Okay, so that's fine. Pent, I'll have him go in the tree over here. I'll have Louise wait for them to come in. Will can go over here. And I think the time for running is over. I think it's now time to bring the fight to them, because I don't see any more point in running away. I just want to stall a little bit longer. Okay, everybody, This is it! Full-scale war! This is now! It's time! To duel! There we go. And Ninian, for now, I'll have you sit here. Okay, let's go. Oh, they can just go after the tent, which apparently they cannot hit a tent. You can't hit a tent. Oh, shoot! Okay, no double attack, we're fine. We're fine. Alright, fine, I'm cool with that. That's not a bad turn, actually. Now we got these jerks coming in as well. Ooh. Okay. With that being said, let's get Raph the heck out of here. Will, let's get this party started. Iron Bow, definitely a steel bow, shoot him out. There we go. Okay. Now, I'm gonna move Hawkeye forward, and I guess I'm gonna attack with the hand axe, and... Yeah, I'm gonna attack with the hand axe. Another crit! Oh my... Hawkeye! I love you, man. What are you... I don't know what steroids you're on, but I want some, because those are very good, apparently. Oh god, why did I just say that? Everyone's gonna quote that. Anyways, moving on. Okay, Raph, you can go up next, and... Man, Raph, you really aren't doing that much damage. Oh, but it has high crit. Okay, that makes up for it. Alright. Now I get why it doesn't do a lot of damage, because the crit rate's supposed to make up for it. I getcha. Elliewood, how do you do against these guys? Elliewood does absolutely horrendous. Okay. Louise, you know what? You're here for a reason. Let's put you to good use. But then again, I do want you kind of in some sort of protection. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have Osman go forward and hit this guy with Steel Lance, which will definitely knock him out. And you're getting double attacked by a general. There's something wrong with you. And you're a Wyvern Rider. You're supposed to be really quick. I don't get it. What happened? There we go. Ooh, weapon level. I'll take it. Okay. I think that's good, though. I think there's nothing else we really have to do. Good throw of spirit, this guy. Let's see. That's good. That's good. You know what? Yeah, I think that's fine. Let me see, though. Who can he attack? Literally anyone he wanted to, but it looks like he's going after the tent for whatever reason. So I think I will throw an attack at him to weaken him up. So if any does decide to attack any unit, he'll just get destroyed for it. But yeah. And oh crap, this guy's still alive. Right. Okay. Guy. Do your... That works. Go for it. Nice job. Okay. Let's see. You can attack Guy, but you look like you're stuck on the tent, and you could attack him as well. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do then? I'm going to perform a rescue operation. Let's just go over here, and we'll rescue Guy just to make sure nothing happens to him. I guess I could do that for a lot of units who are actually at risk right now. So, like, let me see here. Yeah, I can rescue you, then I can move you back a little bit so you can't get attacked. Can you attack Ninian? You could. I don't recommend it, because if you do attack her, I'm going to kill you, but you could technically if you wanted to. So you know what, Hector? Be the better man and rescue Ninian. There we go. And Lynn, I'm going to have her go into the forest, because then they're definitely not going to hurt. Be able to hit her. And besides that, I'm pretty content where everyone is, except I might move Lewis a little closer. And that will do it. Alright. Oh crap, I completely forgot about Raph. Yeah, right, Raph, I'm sorry. This is gonna suck. Sorry, Raph, I effed up as a tactician. I've been doing really bad, honestly, really. I'm sorry, Raph. I really am. I could have been avoided, but I'm sorry, I suck. Anyways, last turn, you know what? They killed Graf. I'm sick of these people. Let's go in. Let's kill everyone. Yay! Murder! Okay, he's dead. Okay. But seriously though, let's avenge Raph. Let's go all in. Hawkeye, get in there. Destroy him. Use the killer axe. I don't even care. Crit him like everything. Blow away. He's gone. He's dead. No one liked him anyways. Next up, Auden, who's going to die? You, sir. You're next up. Thank you for signing up to be the next contestant on The Price is Right. If you're dead or something. I don't know. I'm ranting. Let's kill everyone. You're next. It's just, silver bow is strong as heck. There we go. Now you, my friend, you're the one who killed Raph. So you know what? Oh, I don't think I can get him to attack him. I can't. Dang it, I wanted to leave him to Hector just so Hector could absolutely destroy him. You know what though? I will kill you with dark magic. I'm going to corrupt your soul. Nice. Okay. You can just go there. You can throw a javelin at him even though it really doesn't matter. There we go. And I don't think there's a way for us to kill him. Aw, there goes our javelin. Oh well. Yeah, I don't think there's a way for us to kill him unless... He's the last one. Okay, yeah. So we can still kill him. Yay! It's kind of risky though. You know what? I'll let him live if he decides to run away. And he did decide to run away, smart boy. Ah! I've had it with being pushed here and there. Withdraw. Ground forces pull back and move quickly. I guess that worked out. Lord Elliwood. Nia and Nils, are you both well? What shall we do, Lord Elliwood? Nurgle's power is returning bit by bit. What do you mean? The woman you faced. She is protected by Nurgle's magic. Her strength, it came from Nurgle? Yes. It won't be long before he's active again. With all of his power restored, we must hurry and gain the power to oppose him. We have to recover the Fire Emblem. If we can do that... Come on, the palace is in an uproar. This is our chance to slip away. Wait, I have an idea. Let's follow them. And this? Leave it to me. I think I might be able to find the Black Fang Fortress. Smart idea, Lin. Track them. This way. The signs are fading, but they're really moving. I think I can track them if they keep this pace. Are you sure? Really? Remember, I'm from Sakura. Burned foot soldiers are slow and clumsy. Enter Sakura, and then are easier to track than rabbits. What do we want to do, Elliwood? Let's put our trust in Lindis. If anyone can do this, she can. Are you serious? Over here, everyone. I can take that as a yes. Ah, I'm so sorry, Raph. Raph, oh, what a terrible wound. I must leave until this wound heals. Forgive me, Raph. I brought you so much trouble. Here, today, and a year ago. Never for a moment felt that you caused me trouble. Lin. My proud sister of Sakura. I'm sad that I will not be with you in the end. The road you follow, Mother Earth's blessings. Raph! I can't tell if he went... I think he died. You know what? No! Enough of the sadness. You know what? I'm gonna be positive for once. We're just gonna say that he took a long nap. There. We'll put it like that. Oh, man. I didn't have to have anyone die that chapter. I goofed up. I completely ignored Raph. I forgot he was even there, if I'm being honest. But yeah, that's going to do it for this chapter of Fire Emblem. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And next time on Fire Emblem, I guess we track all those that group of Black Fang members back to their fortress. And hopefully Lin knows what she's doing or else we might get lost. Anyways, though, that's it. See you guys next time.